Hello everybody, today's October 23rd, 2012. Hopefully this will be a quick video. I'm tired and I want to get some sleep tonight, but I really wanted to get this out there. I have a few different things I wanted to cover. First I wanted to play this. I was listening to Gold Seek Radio's broadcast from this past Saturday. And Robert Ian, who has a website, conquerchange.com, was doing a commentary from a paper that Adrian Douglas wrote in 2010, where he said that there was a 45-to-1 paper to physical market going on in the gold market. I mean, who knows exactly what it is? I heard Jeff Christian from the CPM group say that it was 100-to-1. The silver's the same way. It could be 500-to-1 paper ounces for every physical one backing it. But anyway, he does a good job. I'm just going to play just a tiny little bit of it here so you can hear it. So I'll just put this on just for a minute here, and then I'll give you the two news articles I'm going to have posted over at Moneybags World. So anyway, let me just do this real quick.
Well, unbeknownst to you, your special banker friend has not just sold that 1957 Thunderbird to you. He has sold that same car to 44 other people who all think they actually own it too. I mean, they make payments, they pay secure storage fees, they have a paper title, they can come see it and drive it by appointment. They can brag to their friends at cocktail parties that they have something valuable, but what they think they own is what you also think that you own. 45 people all think and believe they own separate vehicles, but in reality, they all own the same vehicle. The banker has perpetuated a fraud, masking as an illusion of what appears to be a legitimate and sound investment. This scheme works and will continue to work as long as each purchaser of the car believes he or she is the only owner of that car. This can go on for years until one of the owners shows up at the secure storage facility unannounced and demands to take his car for a ride. The problem is another owner of that car is already at the storage facility.
Well, some people are going to disagree with me, but which attracts, I think this is going to happen in the gold and silver market at some point.
Some of whom also believe,
who knows how many years off it is, but just can't go on forever.
It doesn't take long to realize that this bad bank that sold the same vehicle 45 times to 45 different owners is right across the street. The crowd storms the bank, but the executive team is nowhere to be found. Some are in Switzerland. Some have moved to the Cayman Islands. One mysteriously committed suicide. The 45 supposed owners of that vehicle all wanted their vehicle, but in reality, only one could have it. The other 44 people were paid in cash, i.e. paper dollars.
Okay, this paid in cash part. Now this is what, when they had the CFTC hearings a couple years ago, this is what, sorry about that, this is what Jeffrey Christian was saying. Well, it's not a problem that we have 100 ounces of silver sold with only one ounce backing it, because there's plenty of ways we can do a cash settlement. So you believe you have this physical silver protecting you from the demise of the dollar, yet that's what you're going to be dealt out. I mean, it's such a fraudulent thing that's going on. It's hard to believe sometimes. I mean, as I get older, less and less things surprise me. And when you really think about what's going on with the metals, this is why Germany, who's going to repatriate their gold, just came out a couple days ago. They're only requesting 50 tons a year from the Federal Reserve, New York Federal Reserve. over 3 years. They're going to get 150 tons. They have like 3,400 tons. So that's all they can get? I mean, I don't know how much is there. I'm sure there's more than 150 tons stored here in the United States for Germany. Even if it's 500 tons, they should be able to say, I want it now. Get it here in 2 weeks. That can't happen because it doesn't. It's not there. All these, it's all been swapped out and it's all been leased. Eric Sprott did a great breakdown on that. It's like all this gold demand, where's it coming from? It's being leased out from the Western Central Banks. I mean, that's sort of what he was claiming. But I'm wondering, where is all the gold? You know, all the gold I've heard in the world will fit in an Olympic-sized pool that's ever been mined in the entire history of the world. You know, will fit in that pool. Half that pool is probably in Rothschild vaults somewhere. I mean, that family's worth $500, $600 trillion. They probably have half of it. So the whole thing is a paper system that we're on nowadays, and most of it's just stashed away somewhere. I mean, you can get pissed off or whatever because I started saying, you know, we're going to have the demise of the dollar. The dollar's going to collapse back in 2009. It is going to collapse. Who knows the timing on the collapse of the dollar? It's going to collapse. Just, I mean, if you don't agree with me, just open up your dang eyes. I've documented it on my blog. I mean, all these countries that aren't even using it anymore in trade. It's just a matter of time. Lindsey Williams is saying 6 to 8 months, all those dollars are coming home to roost. Well, we'll see if he's right. It's just a matter of time. I've wanted to also say that lately I've heard 5 or 6 different people talking about things coming real quick here in the next few weeks. You know, the Dow's dropped like 3.5% just since last Friday, just in the last 2-3 trading days since the 25th anniversary of Black Monday, 1987 crash in the stock market. So I don't know. I mean, who knows exactly what's going to happen, but I just thought that that was interesting that things starting to seem to turn down. October's a big month for crashes. So we'll have to see what happens there. Let me finish. The best part of this is still right here.
The asset they thought they owned. An asset that was supposed to protect them from the paper dollars they were now receiving. This occurred throughout the world because it was soon discovered that this practice was occurring with 1957 Thunderbirds at banks across the globe. As a result, the marketplace revalued the price of these cars 45 times higher, literally overnight. It took the world by storm. These cars became impossible to obtain at any price. However, the real beneficiaries were the people who already owned one of these cars. I mean, really owned one and kept it secured, not in someone else's garage, but in theirs.
So that's why I'm such a firm believer in having, you know, having something in your hand. Having this in your hand, having it in your house. Not just having a piece of paper that says, ah, I got 1,000 of these suckers. Yeah, see, I got them. Right here, I got them. No, you don't, here, I got this. I really do have this. You don't have them. If it's on this is nothing. Gotta have physical ownership. Anyway, I'm getting too carried away. Let me do these two articles real quick that I'm gonna put over at Moneybags World. New Trend in Gold by Jeff Clark, Senior Precious Metals Analyst at Casey Research. According to a World Gold Council, between 2009 and 2011, total coin and bar purchases up 96%. While the exchange-traded products is down 73%. So there's two really good graphs that you'll want to see on this. I'll link that up over at Moneybags World. Down in the more info section will be the link. And so there's a shifting, you can see on the graphs, a shifting paper coming out of the paper markets, going into physical markets the last couple years. And then the other thing, the silver graph is from CPM Silver Yearbook, the 2012. That's the source of the information on that other graph. And then we have, I'm going to also put up an article, U.S. Mint continues to sell 50 times more silver than gold. This is something Eric Sprotts talked about, James Turks talked about. They both said that they're both selling the same dollar amount of gold to silver. So they're selling 50 times as amount more silver than gold. Now, with the same dollar amount going into both metals, and right now, they're pulling about 9 times the amount of silver out of the ground than gold the past so many years. I mean, you just can't, I don't know how long this can just continue to sell the same amount of gold and silver on a dollar basis. You know, I used $1,710 for gold, and I used, what was it, $32 for silver. And I multiplied it by the 525,000 ounces that's been sold so far of gold by the U.S. Mint and 28.2 million ounces of silver. You get $903 million in silver and $897 million of gold. You know, these are all just rounded off figures here. So about $6 million more sold in gold by the U.S. Mint this year so far. So they're selling a higher dollar amount. And there's 75 times more dollars worth of gold available for purchase. So anyway, I think that's interesting. Some people say it doesn't mean anything. Well, that's fine. You can say whatever you want. You can stuff $1 million of paper money under your mattress and feel safe. Do whatever you want. But, I mean, to me, the writing's on the wall. You've got to have physical silver and gold in your possession. I don't believe in trying to trade in and out of the market. I was just watching a video by Raw Dog, and you know he's saying how basically he doesn't agree with just sitting on a pile of metal. Well, that's fine. I've been sitting on a pile of metal. It's worked out okay for me. So I got most of it back in 2009. But if he's been able to time the market, that's great. I don't, fear and greed work against most people, and I don't think that they can time the market.